And it's a great segue into the next activity area, which is dealing with the way kids feel.
Yes.
And that seems like a pretty full area, and I suspect you have lots of things that address that.
We do. And so the next, as you mentioned, is emotional expressiveness, or how do we express our feelings? How do we express our emotions? And really for children, this is probably one of the largest components of resilience, because we've all seen kids or worked with kids or have children that just have a hard time expressing themselves in a way that is either productive or safe for themselves and others. And so if you can work with kids to teach them ways to talk about the way they feel versus hitting or screaming when they're upset, that really is just the great foundation for all of these other factors that we've been talking about. Because if you have a child that can control themselves emotionally and is able to kind of know where they stand and how to react to other people, it really makes the rest of the skills much easier.
You go into classrooms with particular activities that help bring this out?
We went into a second grade classroom. The children read the book, My Many Colored Days by Dr. Seuss. And this is a great book that takes colors and relates color to emotion.
On bright red days, how good it feels to be a horse and kick my heels.
Then we have a handout in the manual that you can print off and use with the kids, and they're able to relate color to feeling. And so then the children might say, red means that I'm happy, and brown means that I'm angry. And then they take and color their heart picture, and it kind of related then a portion of your heart can feel happy at one time, and then the next minute you might feel kind of mad or frustrated about something.
What makes you feel, and you had this one as joyful, so kind of excited and joyful maybe?
Yes.
What makes you feel joyful?
This kid.
You made the new school, I'm glad you feel that way.
How about you, Tatum? How are you feeling today?
Mad and happy.
How come mad and happy? Can you feel both of those sometimes at the same time? So what's making you feel mad?
I feel bad because I have no friends.
Because of what people have said sometimes. So what's making you feel happy though?
What's making me feel happy is because Friday night, I get to see the inside of my old school.
How do you think you're going to color your heart yet? How are you feeling today?
Joyful and worry-free.
Joyful and worry-free. No worries.
And so this activity really gets them thinking about how we can have many different emotions in one day. And we can have many different feelings in one day. But then in the end, we go back to being us. And we go back to being the people that are really made up of all these different feelings and emotions.
And the behaviors that emanate often are because of those conflicts within the emotions, the behaviors that cause problems?
Yeah, I think sometimes kids aren't able to recognize the true emotion that they're experiencing. So sometimes a child might be acting mad, but really when you talk to them, you realize, hey, you're really sad or you're really hurt. But the safe way of showing that is through anger. And oftentimes we see that even with adults. Sometimes we'll be really frustrated about something, but instead of saying, I'm frustrated, we kind of lose our temper or get mad.